Hi, this is the second of two separate piano tutorials on the second cadenza in Liszt's Liebestraum No. 3. If you don't have the sheet music, there are free PDF scores available to download at the IMSLP Public Domain Music Library from a link in the video info box below. There are two methods of practicing cadenza 2. This video demonstrates the more advanced of these two methods. A related video, linked also in the video info, covers the basic method. The rest of Liebestraum is covered in a separate tutorial. Now, I'll play cadenza 2 in 8 different ways. There will hopefully be slight differences between each one, which I'll talk about in detail with the score in a separate interpretation tutorial, which I'll link in the video info. This is what the cadenza sounds like without the influence of that big E-flat 7 chord. Liszt was a composer, pianist, organist, conductor, and teacher. Accounts of his improvisations at the piano and organ are legendary. Aside from his piano works, he wrote sacred and secular choral music, an opera, orchestral works, music for piano and orchestra, chamber music, organ music, and songs. The catalogue of Liszt's piano works alone is immense. Writing music for Liszt so prolifically came about through his extraordinary powers of improvisation. Chopin's work too, from the accounts of its contemporaries, such as his artist friend Eugène Delacroix. Delacroix often heard Chopin play and called Chopin's written compositions mere distillations of his improvisations. A life-changing moment for Liszt was hearing Paganini play the violin in Paris in 1832 when Liszt was 21. This musical awakening left such a deep impression on Liszt, he cloistered himself away from the world like a hermit and practiced piano, it's said, 17 hours a day. By all accounts, scales, arpeggios, exercises, cadenzas, and so on. Liszt emerged after 1 year the Paganini of the piano, no doubt also spurred on by being surrounded by a hotbed of pianists equally dedicated to developing and perfecting piano technique, collectively known as the Flying Trapeze School of Piano. Liszt went on to mix his gift for improvisation into his concert performances. That year of scales and exercises well prepared him to improvise scale and interval-based cadenzas spontaneously into his improvisations as his mood and imagination took hold. And these found themselves in his written compositions, such as the cadenzas in Liebestraum. Cadenza 2 is a straightforward double third chromatic scale, hands in unison. Right hand has a major third, left a minor. That's basically it. This major and minor combination adds musical colour. The texture is right hand third as a melodic interval, top note to the bottom, repeated, and the left hand the reverse, repeated. So cadenza 2 can be thought of in part as a musically imaginative chromatic scale in thirds. The two Liebestraum cadenzas transition and join together contrasting sections. Cadenza 1 modulates the opening slower section in the key of A flat to the quicker pace of the follow-on section, lifting upwards in key and mood a minor third to B major. As the music quickens in tempo, Liszt modulates upwards again from B to C. As the music builds up further in drama to the climax, Liszt cleverly manages all the while to get back to the opening key of A flat. Cadenza 2 is not used to transition two keys as is cadenza 1, but instead to cool down the passionate climax to get back full circle to the lyrical, calm opening mood. Cadenza 1 and 2 can be thought of, on one hand, as compositional devices to transition contrasting keys, to contrast with and join together contrasting moods. And, on the other hand, if truth be told, are opportunities for a little burst of freestyle virtuosity for the pianist. Here's a suggested fingering for the double third scales right and left hand. If these scales are relatively new to you, you'll find they're not difficult to play as they may first appear. Putting Liebestraum as music aside, if cadenza 2 encourages you to practice double third scales right and importantly left hand, you'll find they are one of the best, if not the best, of all finger exercises. Starting point for the metronome is 80. A suggested tempo for the rundown is still only around 100 to 120, which is a very moderate tempo for double third scales. Reaching this tempo, again if double third scales are new to you, should not be too challenging. It's important to feel the beat rhythmically when you're playing, so accent the beats with the metronome occasionally when practicing. Although you won't accent the beats in performance, it's still important to have the sense of that rhythmical beat, especially at a fast tempo.
For comfort, practice in the middle of the piano. Occasionally, shift back to the top, as it's also important to get used to how your fingers feel when they play in relation to the angle of your wrists. You might also find playing the cadenza is a combination of a little leaning over to the right and adjusting the angle of your wrists. Whatever feels best, try to stick to it each time you play. Between 110 and 120 is about as fast as this cadenza ever gets played. This is still a very moderate tempo for double third scales. If you feel comfortable playing thirds at this tempo, your cadenza will whiz down comfortably. This cadenza as a whole can be played in many different ways. If you choose to divide hands, this section can be played very fast indeed, without too much difficulty. The minor seconds down contrast with the major and minor thirds and can also be divided, but you might find after practice they are just as easy to play with one hand. If you have a sostenuto pedal on your piano, you can hold the E-flat 7 chord throughout cadenza 2. This is an interpretive choice and something interesting to listen out for in performances and recordings. That big E-flat 7 chord itself can be played in many ways and gives a contrasting, almost orchestral texture when it's held with sostenuto steadily against the descending chromatic scale played without sustain pedal, as indicated on the score. This indicates the sustain pedal is held throughout the cadenza's preceding bar and released about halfway down the first octave of the chromatic run. This cadenza calls for a degree of clarity of execution, so beware not to overuse the sustain pedal, especially at fast tempos.
Right foot sustain, left foot sostenuto. Sustain first. Sostenuto down. Sustain up. And the sostenuto can keep ringing if you choose to play the rest of the cadenza with the E-flat chord.
I use the harmonic pedal in my cadenza examples at the beginning of the video, which I talk about in detail in a related video specifically on the harmonic pedal in Liszt cadenzas. Here's my suggested fingering for the whole cadenza. If you choose to stick to the fingering of the double third scales, just change fingers on C and E to 4 and 2 instead of 4 and 1. You can download these image files from an album on my piano Facebook page.
As mentioned, a piano tutorial covering a basic method to play cadenza 2 is linked in the video info and posted as a video reply. My full performance of Liebestraum is also linked in the info box. Thanks for watching and hope you find this tutorial useful.